Students, today's topic that I am going to cover is known as Rules of Civility, Diner Etiquettes for Formal Dining. Myself, Amit Gupta, Assistant Professor with the Chitkara School of Hospitality. The scope or the content that we are going to cover in the following slides is introduction to the formal dining, dining etiquette civility, variety of formal dining and formal dining on a continuum. These are the few things that I am going to cover in this coming slides. Let's move forward. Introduction. An invitation to a formal dinner is an event not to be missed. I think we all agree that whenever a formal dinner invitation comes, we should go out there. We will discuss what to expect and how to prepare for this ancient and highly ritualized event of the formal dining. Now, there are a variety in formal dining. It is based on few of the context. We should know the context of your dinner in every important, because we need to know what kind of formal dinner it is, so we have to prepare ourselves accordingly. Will the dinner occur in Boston, London, Paris, Berlin or Shanghai? Yes, the location is very important. There are certainly differences between countries, and there are also differences within countries regarding the formal dining etiquettes. Formal dining in on a continuum. Let's begin. Dining exists on a continuum from the most basic informal meal to the most lavish royal dinner. I hope you all agree with this. Within formal dining, a 5-course meal served in a 3-star Michelin restaurant is very different from a smaller dinner at Buckingham Palace. We all know what is a Buckingham Palace. While dining at a Michelin star restaurant is far more formal compared to many dining experiences, it is still the least formal of a formal dining experience. A formal dining event is distinguished from an informal one in several ways. A formal diner requires a man to wear an evening attire such as a tuxedo or something even white tie. Sometimes even white tie. All food is served from the kitchen. Guests do not handle serving platters nor do they pass dishes. Neither serving dishes nor utensils are placed on the table. All service and table clearing is performed by the butlers and other service staff members. A formal dinner is also distinguished by multiple courses as well as by the serving of demitasse, brandy and liqueurs. What distinguishes a formal dinner from all the others dinner is the order of service and the sitting protocol, because everyone is invited and their sitting is being planned beforehand, so people are supposed to be sitting at their respective place. Before the event, RSVP, response to an invitation should be handwritten. Once you receive the invitation letter for the formal dinner, you have to send your acceptance for the invitation, either whether you are coming or not. If in case telephone number, email address is being provided in the invitation letter, then you can send a formal letter to the consignee telephone number or to the email address regarding your acceptance or not coming for that particular event. Formal event may have 100 or invitees, particularly as at embassies, whereas for the royal family of Great Britain may host dinner with a few thousand guests. I hope you all agree, because they have a very lavish. Formal evening attires. The gentleman gazette review of the tuxedos worn at evening reception of the royal wedding offers great suggestion on how to dress classically and appropriately. Your event may even acquire the wearing of white tie, as if you are not sure about the appropriate dress. What to expect at a formal dinner? Food service proceeds to the right counterclockwise, starting with the guest of honor. Beverage service progresses to the left clockwise. At a formal dinner, individual portions are pre-arranged and presented on a platter. The greater the courses, the smaller the portion and the less wine poured per course. Formal dining includes multiple courses and second helping are not offered. Once serverware is taken from the dining area, it is not returned. Food is served on a hot or cold plate. A plate's temperature will be appropriate to the food they contain. Beverages are served and cleared from the right side. The goblet and other wine glasses remain on the table throughout the entire meal. Only the sherry glass is removed at the end of the course it accompanies. With your permission, the butler will remove the wine glass if you inform him that you are allergic or prefer not to drink If the same wine is offered over consecutive courses, it is served in the same glass. Orders of service. Seating arrangement varies somewhat based on whether or not restrict protocol is being followed. If strict protocol is being followed, then men escort women to their seats. Formal dinners still follow some formal gendered behavior, with an equal number of men and women in attendance and men standing until the host is seated. If the occasion is more relaxed, women may seat themselves before the hostess. Many formal dinners fit honored guests. If there is an honored guest, then guest is served first. The man of honor sits to the right of the hostess and the lady of honor sits to the right of the host. While the host escorts the lady of honor to her chairs and pull out the chair on his right and seats her, the hostess is escorted to her chair by the man of honor. By the gentleman on her left pulls out her chair and seats her. Once the honor guest is served, service begins with the lady of honor and moves counterclockwise. When no honored guest is present, service may begin with the most important female guest. The order of service commences with the lady of honor. How the remaining guests are served is often determined by the size of the banquet and how strictly protocol is being followed. Place setting at formal dinners. Because the number and type of courses varies, so two will be the place setting. In the most formal of settings, the dessert fork and spoons are brought to the table for the dessert course. For less formal settings, the fork and spoons are placed on the table above the plate, fork pointing right, spoon pointing left. When more courses are to be served, the table is laid only for soup, fish and meat. The menu. Courses vary by occasion and may be as few as 4 courses or as high as 21 courses. The first class meal on the Titanic is believed to have been 10 courses. Much care goes into the preparation and execution of the menu. The goal is to create an experience where flavors complement one another and no taste is too overpowering. Temperatures and color are contrasted throughout the meal. A formal dinner is designed to last for hours and the course timing accounts for this fact. Composed dishes remains on the table throughout. The dinner and the guest may freely help themselves usually between courses. A sorbet intermezzo may be served at the midway point of large meal. Thank you. I hope I would have been able to define you the presentation in a proper way. Looking forward for another class in the coming time. Thank you. Have a great day ahead. Bye-bye.